okay. I get to introduce Patrick. So this is Patrick Dunn. Patrick was generous enough with his time, on top of all of his ridiculous amount of PTA commitments, to step up to taking on the presidency of the Gifted and Talented Association of Montgomery County, which is a 501c3 organization founded to advocate for the needs of gifted children in Montgomery County. And the great thing about GTA, as compared to MCCPTA, which is the organization that I and Kim and Lang represent, is that it can move quickly and it is solely focused on the needs of gifted kids. MCCPTA is the Montgomery County Council of PTAs. It is a countywide organization. It only takes decisions after every PTA in the county has had the opportunity to consider them. It takes us 2 months to move forward on just about anything. GTA is our nimble cousin who can actually whip up a petition in a week and get something done. So please give Patrick your attention.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for your persistence. Number one skill set that you will need to advocate for your children. You know that. Persistence. Social emotional learners, you all are. We too can use the jargon. Patience. If you don't have patience, you will go insane. That may be helpful for some people, because then they can write you off. Persistence, patience. Partner. If you're doing it alone, you're going to be doing an amazing job as a Sisyphus, pushing that stone up, and it will roll back on top of you. There's 154,000 students, there's a whole bunch of staff, teachers, principals, central office. If it's against you, what chance do you have? There are people, Michelle, Kim, Amanda, who have done advocacy, and effectively. They've made progress. If you choose not to learn from them, so be it. But there are opportunities to learn from them and others. So the Gifted and Talented Association of Montgomery County is one of those opportunities to learn from each other. So when Michelle notes, we should be indicating school names. Who's doing what well, and who's doing what poorly? Now, historically, the GTA Forum has had a cast of characters who comment upon a wide range of education issues. And some of them are GT related. That's fair. They'll own up to it. More recently, the conversations have been more few in number, but I would suggest actually more focused on GT, right? But there are not nearly enough. Everyone here who hasn't signed up for a GTA listserv subscription, you can do digest, you can do daily. It would be very helpful if you're at least listening to the conversation. It would be that much more helpful if you are participating in the conversation, even if it's, yes, I've experienced that at this school, or no, I haven't had that, but I have seen this. So as the GT liaison, you're serving as the point person at your school to communicate with your parents and your teachers and your staff. You don't have to do it alone. You get to, if you choose to, invoke the collective knowledge, lore, persistence, patience of GT advocates at the county level. And the Montgomery County PTA Gifted Child Committee is one source of valuable information, and GTA is another. GCC, Gifted and Child Committee, is the official announcements, if you will, and GTA is a lot of times conversations about the official announcements and what's working and what's not so much working. All right? So we have persistence, we have patience, we have partnering, and of course we have parents. It will be disappointing at times. You know that. You're dealing with a very large bureaucracy. Many of them have no incentive or disincentive to deal with a group of children who are not federally titled. Right? So we don't have that imprimatur. We are the whiners. Fair enough. I will whine for my child, absolutely. If you want to call that your version of advocacy, I will take on that title. I will not stop whining. I have been part of advocacy groups at the middle school level, elementary school, not as much, but middle school, where programs which had been promised were going to be cut. You've never seen more motivated parents in a room with more energy than you dare cut a program that you promised to my child. That was one of the reasons that they chose to go through all the testing and extra work for the middle school magnet program. You've never seen parents so motivated when they said, well, for a budget cutting measure, do they really need bus transportation across the county for a magnet school? Okay, so fundamental programs cut, we came out. And we chanted. Well, not so much chanting, but you know, we could. We really need a GT chant, so think about that. There's your homework. But for things like regular implementation of common sense measures, this group of kids is below grade level. This group of kids is above grade level. This group of kids is on grade level. And you dynamically assess them on a regular basis and say, okay, what do they need? What do they need? What do they need? If everybody is advanced, then what does advanced mean? Every child takes advanced science, English, social studies in the middle school. So clearly they don't understand the definition of advanced. However, they can get away with it because it's a policy decision and we've just advanced everybody. It's the achievement gap that has disappeared. There is no gap in attendance by different groups of people participating in different classes because now there is only one class with which you participate. So you have below grade level kids bored to tears because they don't get it and there's nobody helping them. And you have above grade level kids bored to tears because they get it and it's not challenging. And you have on grade level bored kids to tears because the other 40% are acting out for whatever reasons. We all fail. Congratulations. Yes, we have succeeded. There is no gap. So another way of thinking about the achievement gap disappearing, No Child Left Behind, is all about thresholds. You get here, that's all we care about. We get a certain number of kids from this group, pass a threshold, enough said, you've passed the race, that's all there is. Whether you went further or faster is immaterial to us. You get no credit. In fact, if you spend any effort on those kids, you don't spend the effort on these kids, and therefore you would get punished severely. Excellent plan, clearly designed by politicians. There is no systematic attempt that I'm aware of, Michelle's aware of, where every child is assessed, and then the progress that they make in given intervals of time is assessed, and that's the level of achievement. That is the differentiated instruction that we all would like to see. You start here, and within a certain time period, there's an on-grade level achievement to here. There's an above-grade level metric for that, and then if you're not meeting those, then it's not above, it's not on-grade level, right? That doesn't exist. That's common sense. It's really hard. It's much easier to set thresholds. You make it, oh, we're good. So we advocate for what? We advocate for public school transportation for a magnet school program if it's going to get cut. We advocate for a program when it's going to get cut. Are we very good at advocating for making sure that the teachers have instruction about how to teach GT kids? Not so much. Do we advocate for dynamic grouping? Not so much. All right. How many here get the GTA emails? Hands, please. Okay. How many here are thinking now that they should get the GTA emails? How many here are thinking, maybe not only will I get the emails, but every once in a while, quarterly, semester, I'll actually send in a note. That's why we have an issue with the excellence gap.
So is this a self-help group, or are we going to do something?
There are two answers to that. So yes and yes.
What was the question?
Is it a self-help group, or are we actually going to do something? So what is there to do? Well, historically, GTA was founded by folks who were attempting to resist efforts to completely gut, whatever legislative mandate there was for gifted and talented education in the county. So it was founded not because people said, there's an excellence gap, we should work on that. It was founded because there was a profound threat to any chance of differentiated instruction for GT kids. So it was a cut threat. And that got people motivated, and we responded, all right? We've had other threats, and we respond to that. But now we have a greater challenge to ourselves. We have to advocate, as Michelle said, on a regular basis, for regular things, for the common sense things. Dynamic grouping, teacher instruction, parent communication. If you assert that there is differentiated instruction enrichment, what is it looking like? How do I know? Why is there not a portal that allows me to see what the kids are doing? My kid. This is one of the most technologically advanced districts in the country, probably. And yet, you try to penetrate the firewall. They're very good at that. It's intellectual property, the curriculum. You have no window to the details. You have the summary level. Yes, the curriculum is available. But what is the enrichment? What are the details? Some people have found that out. And if you're not sharing those details with each other, I suggest that you're actually not doing your civic responsibility to yourself, to your child, and to the other people who are sharing your concerns. We do have to work together. We must partner. That means writing to Board of Ed, County Council. When County Council whines that the school system is failing miserably, and they do every year, at educating the Montgomery County children, even though 50% of the county budget goes to MCPS, I push back and say, but how are you measuring that? Do you ask for an excellence gap evaluation? Do you ask for the progress of every child? No, you take thresholds just like everyone else does. And yes, there some significant number are not meeting basic needs, but you never ask the question, County Council, or your delegates, what about the kids who are really good and aren't getting really better? That's never asked. So we hold Board of Ed responsible. We hold County Council. If you're not sending letters to the Gazette, the Washington Post, listen to Jay Matthews, read it and comment. Some people get really nasty. You don't have to. Some people do. But you could call them. Really, Jay? The only criteria is participation? Okay, it's a good threshold level of measure of success. But how about something a little bit more rigorous, like success? Threes. Okay, how many people think that a 3 on an AP level course will actually get you very far at the University of Maryland? No. You've just got credit for doing well by showing up and getting C minus. Maryland's gonna say, thanks for trying, thanks for playing. You've just done pre-college preparation. Excellent. You'll get no credit. If you think that's credit, you're sadly mistaken. 5, yes. So how many people get 5s? How many times do we see the metric for 5 within every demographic group that you want to split it up? You don't see that. That's putting the achievement gap away. So we have to advocate. County Council, Board of Ed, Washington Post, make Donna St. George very busy in her inbox. She's actually a very lovely person. Get Jay Matthews filled up with comments every time he mouths off and you don't like it, or you like it. Some things that Jay writes, I was like, wow, you got a clue. Fabulous. Yes, the idea is borrowed from somebody else, but you gave credit in your column for the idea. Excellent. And then talk to each other. At the very least, send an email to GTA saying, I'm lost, I'm happy, I'm hopeful. We need to talk more to each other. I don't post that often. Why? My child has actually been incredibly fortunate. Her GT status has not been encumbered by impediments thrown her way. I'm lucky. I've seen impediments almost come her way, and I worked with a whole bunch of other people to make sure we cut those off at the knees. And they didn't touch that, except as a third rail, you touch it and you die possibility. But there are lots of people here and at your home schools that have impediments in their way, and we have an opportunity to work on that. We as GTA need help. The website, we need a webmaster. I go in occasionally and modify things. I'm not good at it, and I'm really slow doing it. Facebook, I don't do Facebook. I don't understand it. I mean, I get it, but emails, send those things out. So we need help. And I've done GTA presidents for 2 years. Time for somebody else to share the joy. My daughter's a junior at Poolsville. Right? My son, his gifts are many, but not necessarily within that this realm. You all have to think about where you want to take this going forward. Michelle's still here for a while. She's incredibly busy. Don't even think about asking her to take this on. Amanda, Lang Lin, Kim, they're working at PTA level. Somebody else needs to think about getting the GTA entity fired up again about regular stuff. Because the regular stuff affects you and your child every day. Thank you very much. Amanda points out that I was negligent until. So there's a page over there. Posting messages, subscribing, and how to become a member. We really need help with getting membership process rebuilt. Thank you very much. $15 a year. It's actually pretty small. Okay? Yes. Oh, also for those of you who are middle school and high school parents, we hosted with the GCC how to get ready for college. We had a really cool college advisor come in, and her handouts are over there on the table. So that's one of the things we do outside of MCS for GT enrichment.